My name is Kerry Hampton and I'm a registered nurse and a registered midwife, and I work in general practice teaching women about fertility awareness and preconception healthcare. My research was motivated by observations that I had made in clinical practice over many, many years. There seemed to be a very strong association between women's poor knowledge of fertility awareness and having trouble conceiving. I became acutely aware of how very little women actually knew. I also became very aware that women overestimated the amount of knowledge that they actually had. So it was a matter of engaging with women and then looking at what they know and then helping them understand their cycle. And of course, the most accurate way of women being able to identify the fertile time in their menstrual cycle is through an understanding of mucus, because mucus enables women to have a knowledge of their menstrual cycle, or the fertile time of the menstrual cycle, as it's actually happening. Around 6 days leading up to ovulation, fertile type mucus is released from the cervix, and over that time the mucus changes from not very much at the beginning of that fertile time indicated by mucus to being more obvious around the time of ovulation. And around the time of ovulation, the mucus comprises of about 98% water, so there is a distinct feeling of moistness to wetness around the peak fertile time in the menstrual cycle. So if women developed an understanding of mucus changes in their menstrual cycle, they can tell when they're not fertile, so that's before the mucus begins. They can develop an understanding of what the mucus feels like at the vulva when it first starts coming through to the vulva from the cervix, and then it changes as the water content changes leading up to ovulation. So when the mucus reaches a kind of quite a watery kind of feeling, and then it dramatically stops, that's a very key sign of the transition in the mucus that indicates ovulation. The two other methods of fertility awareness that women rely upon is temperature, but temperature is a retrospective indicator of ovulation. So when the temperature has gone up, that tells a woman that she actually has ovulated. And rhythm, which is what many women use, is only accurate for around about 25 to 30% of women who report having a very monthly menstrual cycle. And in my experience, most women would consider that they're fertile somewhere around about the middle of the menstrual cycle. But women can be fertile much earlier than they think they are, and they can be fertile in their cycle much later than they think they are. And in fact, fairly recent research has found that there is much more variability in the timing of the fertile window than women actually understand, and that their health practitioners actually understand.